Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can do a daily rewards command within Discord.js. So an example of this, let's say that I do exclamation point daily. I'll then say you have already claimed your daily rewards today. So if I go to MongoDB right here, we see the updated at is for today. I click on find, we see that it's still the same. Now if I go to actually update this, like let's say we go for yesterday at the same time, so I change the 13th, which is today's date, to the 12th. I click on update. I could then restart my bot. Then I can run exclamation point daily. And it'll then say you have claimed your daily rewards. Now if I click on find, we see that this updated to the correct time. And if I try daily one more time, it says you've already claimed your daily rewards today. So this is the bot we're going to actually create here. And what you actually give them as daily rewards is completely up to you. So for example, you could give them XP or something else. I'll leave that to you, but I'm going to show you in this video how you can create the system that will check if they've ran the daily command once every 24 hours. And real quick, before we get started, if you guys do need help with anything, please leave a comment down below, or better yet, join the Warren Off Keys Discord and ask there. If you leave a comment on either of those two places, I'll do my best to get back to you. So let's get started here. I have this project, and you can find a link to that within the GitHub repository in the video description. And I'm going to go inside of my schemas folder, and I'm going to go ahead and make a new file. This will be called daily-rewards-schema.js. And then within here, we are going to import mongoose. So constant mongoose, require mongoose. And then we're going to create an actual schema, daily-rewards-schema. Equals mongoose.schema with a capital S, and we're going to pass in an object. Now here we get to define what our actual schema is going to be, but real quick, I'm going to create a constant. I'm going to call this rec string for required string, and this is going to say a type of string, and required is true. This is something that you should be familiar with if you followed my previous videos. So now we want to actually have a guild ID, which will be a required string, and a user ID, which will be another required string. Now, something that I've covered within my Mongoose series, which I suggest you check out if you're looking to get better at Mongoose, is the second object here within our schema. We can pass in some options here. For example, we can say timestamps is true, and this will automatically use created at and updated at timestamps, which you see right here. I didn't do this manually. This is something that MongoDB will do for us if we pass in the timestamps attribute here. Now, finally, we actually have to export this to module.exports. Equals mongoose.model. This is going to take in two arguments. The first one is the collection name. So this can be daily-rewards. The second one can be the actual collection. So daily reward schema. I could then save and close this file. I'm then going to go inside of my commands directory. This will be using the Commando framework to handle our commands. If you need to know more about Commando, then a link to that will be in the video description. I have a video covering how to set that up. Now within our command directory, I'm going to make a new folder. This will be called economy. And within here, I'm going to make a new file. This will be called daily.js. So now I need to import commando. So constant commando with a capital C equals require discord.js-commando. And then I need to import mongo. So const mongo equals require at util/mongo. If you don't have your import set up like this, you can just import the correct path going into your mongo directory. But within this series, I've shown you how to actually set up your imports like this, so a link to the video on how to do this will be within the video description. Next, we have to import our schema, so const daily rewards schema equals require, and I'm going to do at schemas/daily-rewards-schema. This is going to be the same exact file name that we just created. Now we need to actually export a class, so I can say module.exports equals class daily command extends commando.command lowercase o. Now we can actually set up our command. So we're going to have our constructor function, which will have a client as an object, and then we can call super, which is going to invoke the constructor function for our extended class. In this case, it is commando.command. This is going to take in two arguments. So we have our client, and then we have some options. Now within here, I'm going to pass in the name, which will be daily. And then I'm going to pass in the group, the economy, And before we continue here, we actually have to set up this group. So going inside of our index file, we can scroll down to when we're registering the groups. And I'm going to add a new one. This will be called economy. The second element here within this array will be another string that'll say commands for economy system. Then I can go ahead and save and close this. Now the next property is going to be the member name, which will also be daily. And then we have the description, it claims daily rewards. Now we have to create an asynchronous run function that'll actually be ran whenever this command is ran. And then within here, we're going to have our message argument. This will be the actual message itself. Before I continue, we need to go above our actual class here, but below our imports. We need to actually store different pieces of data within memory using an array. So I'm going to add a comment here so it can be better understood. We're going to say array of member IDs who have claimed their daily rewards in the last 24 hours. Then I can say resets every 10 minutes. And I'll explain the exact details of why we're resetting it and all that soon. But first, let's go through and write the code. So I'm going to say let claimed cache equals an empty array. This is basically going to be a list of member IDs who have actually claimed their daily rewards so far. And then this will clear every 10 minutes. But what's important here is that if they go to run the command and they are inside of this cache or inside of this array, then it's going to essentially just say, hey, you've already claimed your rewards. You can't do it yet. And so that way we don't have to actually fetch the from the database, which is going to be slower than just checking the actual array here. Now, the reason why we are clearing it is so if someone now has the ability to claim the rewards, let's say it's been exactly 24 hours and 5 minutes or whatever it might be, we don't want them to be stuck inside of here where they can't actually claim it. Also, if your bot is in very large discords, a lot of data is going to be added into this, and depending on how you're hosting your bot, that could pose problems depending on a couple different factors, but it's better to be on the safe side. So now we're going to actually create a function that is going to be invoked every 10 minutes. So I'm going to say const clear cache. This is going to be a basic function. I'm not going to write anything in there yet because first we want to make sure that we actually call this function. So this function will be called whenever this file is actually imported. And then inside of here, we're going to want to say claimed cache equals an empty array, which will then clear it. I can then say set timeout, which will run a specific function after a certain number of milliseconds. So that function is going to be called clear cache. And that milliseconds is going to be 1000, which is how many milliseconds there is in a second, times 60. So this is going to be however many minutes. In this case, it'll be 1 minute at the moment. And then times 10. So this will be 10 minutes. So every 10 minutes, this function will be ran. And obviously when the bot starts up, it will immediately be ran because of line 13. And so our cache will be cleared every 10 minutes. You can change this to something else if you want 5 minutes or if you want 60 minutes or whatever you want. But I do suggest that you clear this cache every so often. So now that we have that, we can go down to our run function and we can actually make the functionality work. There's a few pieces of information we actually want from the message. So we can destructure those. So constant guild and member. And then we can destructure those from the message object. And then we want to get access to the ID, which we can also destructure from the member object. Now, the very first thing we want to do before we actually connect to Mongo or any database you might be using is we need to see if this member is inside of our claimed cache. If so, we don't want to actually reach out to the database and we want to immediately say that they cannot claim it yet. So if claimed cache.includes, we can pass in the ID. This is going to return true or false depending on if this ID or whatever you pass into here is inside of the array. Now here we can actually do a console log. We can say returning from cache. And then we can also say message.reply. You have already claimed your daily rewards. Then we have to return, which is important because this is going to make it so we're not going to run the rest of the code. Now afterwards, we're going to actually fetch from Mongo, and I'm going to add another console log here. So console log fetching from Mongo. And the reason why I'm adding these console logs is so we make sure that the cache is actually working. So now we're going to actually connect to Mongo. And so because this run function is asynchronous, I can say await Mongo, and this returns a promise. So dot then, this is going to return a function that has to also be asynchronous, and it'll have one argument, which is Mongoose. And then within this function, we need to use try and finally to make sure that our connection is closed whenever we're done with it. So mongoose.connection .close is how we actually do that. Within our try block, we're going to go ahead and see if this user within this guild is inside our database. So const results equals await. Now we have to access the actual schema. So daily reward schema dot find one. And so we're going to actually pass in an object here. However, this object is something we're going to use multiple times. So it's best that we declare it once and reuse that same object. So we're going to say const obj for object. This is going to say guild ID is equal to guild.id. We have access to guild from destructuring it on line 26. And then we can say user ID is accessed by ID, which is this variable right here. Now the spelling of these has to exactly match what you put inside of your schema. So if I open this up, we see guild ID with a capital I and user ID with a capital I. And that's why I have these typed exactly like that. So scrolling down, instead of this object, we can just say find one and pass in our object variable. And then for now, I just want to console log the results. So just like this, we will save this. And then I need to make sure that this is deleted from Mongo. I'm going to go in here and I'm going to delete this. Going back, I can actually run this. So I can start my code with node index.js. And then I can run exclamation point daily. And it's going to say fetching from Mongo, result is null. So we will want to actually check to see if the result is something that exists. However, we're going to come back to this. For now, I'm just going to write an empty if statement just like this. Afterwards, though, we're going to assume that result is null because we haven't actually written any code to save this inside of the collection. So at this point, I can say await daily reward schema dot find one and update. This is going to take in three arguments. The first two will be the actual object we've already defined. The second one will be an object, which will say upsert is true. This is something I've covered in detail in many other videos, so I'm just going to not explain this too much here. But moving forward, we do want to make sure that the user is now inserted inside of our cache. So claimed cache.push, which is how you're going to actually insert something into an array, claimed cache.push, and then ID, which is going to be the user ID that we've destructured on line 27. Then we can reply to the user. So message.reply, have claimed your daily rewards. Now you might want to customize this however you want. Also important right here, you want to actually give the rewards. So it completely depends on what you want for your rewards. I can't make a video and expect everyone to do the same thing, so I can't really cover this here. If you want to give experience, then I have videos on economy stuff. If you want to give other things, then that might be up to your own implementation. But at this point is when you want to give the rewards. So at this point, we have one last step, and that's to actually finish this if statement. But real quick, I'm going to test this to make sure it actually saves to our database. So I'm going to save the file and I'm going to restart the bot. Going back into Mongoose, we click on find and we see nothing in here. But if I go into Discord and I run exclamation point daily, it'll say you have claimed your daily rewards. If I click on find, we now see this right here with created at and updated at. Now, because we are adding the user to this array, we should now see a message if I try and type it right here, exclamation point daily. It'll say you've already claimed your daily rewards. Now, if I restart the bot, it's going to act like I have not claimed them yet. So if I run this, it should say right here, you have claimed your daily rewards. And that's because inside of our if statement, checking if the results exist, we're not actually doing anything. But if we look inside of our console log now shows results. So we're going to want to do a date comparison, and this is actually fairly simple to do. First, I'm going to make a constant called then, which is going to be representing the actual date in the results. We can say equals new date, and then we need to pass in results.updated at. It's important that you use updated at and not created at. We could then use .getTime, which will actually return the exact number of milliseconds representing this date. Then I can say const now equals new date with no parameters .getTime. So then is going to be when it was last updated in the database, therefore when the person last claimed their rewards, and now is going to be obviously right now. Now we can get the difference in milliseconds, so we'll call this diff time. This is going to be equal to an absolute value, so math.abs for absolute value. We can do now minus then. I can then create another constant called diff days equal to math.round, and then we're going to have diff time divided by some type of calculation. So like I explained earlier, there's 1,000 milliseconds within a second, and so this calculation right here is going to be equivalent to 10 minutes. So we want to do something similar down here. We're going to say 1,000, which is a certain number of seconds, times 60, so now we're talking about minutes, times 60, so now we're talking about hours, times 24, so we're now talking about days. Then I can say if days is less than or equal to 1, we can then say claimed cache.push ID, because at this point, the person is not inside of the ID, or not inside of the array rather, because it would have returned up here. But this is likely going to be the scenario whenever this is ran, if they have claimed it, that the bot restarted for whatever reason, or that the claimed cache was restarted, or reset rather, within our clear cache function. Now we want to make sure that they are inserted back into the cache because they are running the command, and that we want to tell them that you have already claimed your rewards. So we can actually go up and copy this exact message right here, and then we can say message.reply, you already claimed your rewards, and then we can return. Actually, it might be proper if we put this inside of a variable. So up here, I can say constant already claimed equals the string, and then here we can reply with already claimed. And then down here, we can reply with already claimed. That way, if we go to update this, you have to update it in just one place. Now, if I save this and I restart, I can then go into Discord and I can run exclamation point daily. And it'll say you've already claimed your daily rewards. Now, here it says fetching from Mongo because it doesn't have anything to fetch from the cache. But now at this point, our ID has been added to the cache. So I can run exclamation point daily and it'll say you have already claimed your daily rewards. We noticed that was much faster. That's because it's just checking an in-memory cache, which is much faster than a database. This is one reason why we're using the cache, so it's faster after the first try. And then here we see returning from cache, and so we know that we didn't actually connect to Mongo for that case. And so this is how you're going to create a command that can only be ran once per day. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Worn Off Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.